Hey everyone, this is Manly Badass Drew, and welcome back to Life is Strange. Previously in Life is Strange, we returned to the present after making a hard decision.
Chloe, you're back.
Whoa, down, Max. You get one kiss, now you're all over me?
I'm so glad you're here.
You sound high, but thanks for the morning grope. Since we were up all night playing CSI Arcadia Bay, I was still spaced out here trying to put all this info together. Max, did you forget we've gone over this? I hope you weren't messing around with time while I was sleeping.
Animation froze up.
I'm
God.
Just spaced out too.
Welcome back to the real world, Max.
Let's look at the big board and see all our pieces in the puzzle so far.
I'm getting lost in all this shit.
Staying up all night is the best excuse to drink lots of coffee.
Or you can just be like me and drink lots of coffee all the time. No excuse
even
needed.
Holmes and Watson didn't use every piece of information. Damn. This is a serious expose on the Prescotts. Finally.
It's a lot of text. I'm gonna kind of read over this real quick. Pan Estates. Typical ways of making a shitload of money. Insider property deals.
That's my Chloe.
Bad girl's got the gun. When your skull bully has got a pistol, upgrade to an AK-47.
That snow dough always makes me think of William and Chloe.
I feel like we're missing a major clue.
I should have known just erasing that phone message wouldn't stop the police.
It's kind of obvious. Delayed, though.
This butterfly photo seems like a million years ago. How much time have I altered since? I'm so sorry, William. It's not fair you had to die twice.
Pretending they only died once due to how the timeline works, since it seems to be a consistent single timeline rather than a series of parallel dimensions.
There's Chloe's cash stash. Sorry, Principal Wells.
And that's why we took the money. No regrets.
Yes, Chloe Price was here.
Take a photo. Put them on Facebook. She barely even flinched.
I wish I could tell Chloe how much William cared about her.
Time to piece together the clues.
So close yet so far away. We have to do three main things.
Right. What things?
One, decipher Frank's logbook. Two, get Nathan's phone to find out where he's been during the Vortex Club parties with Kate and Rachel. And see whatever hidden shit he's got in his messages.
Three, beat Stepdouche Dan until he tells us about Frank, Nathan, and the Darkroom. And I do have a gun now.
Keep it in your
pants.
A bit much.
We'll have to do this on our own.
Dude, at least let me kick his ass, then rewind. Fine, whatevs. It's your power.
Which I can't waste on shit like that. Or Blackwell would be in big trouble.
At least you let me take that money to pay Frank off.
Don't remind me. I just want him off your back. Our back.
I know. You should get busy in the garage to see what dirt you can dig up. I'm gonna cyberstalk some names and see where that leads. Or to who. And be careful of Stepcrack. He's not gonna be a happy camper after you reamed him yesterday and Mom is giving him the boot.
I'm on it, partner. I can't abuse this level of my rewind power. It's amazing how innocent our drawings were compared to what we're doing now.
It's foreshadowing the future. A wonderful future where animals and people live in peace. Dolphins frolic and play. There's little caricatures of turtles flowing in the water. There's a giant rainbow. As the best couple gets together. Taste the rainbow.
Oh no.
You nut stupid bird.
That poor little bird has been trapped in here.
I'm gonna have to save you every episode, aren't I? It's my spiritual bird. Well, let's make sure the window is open first.
Last time I wanted to splash some water on my face, my whole life changed.
Clean ourselves up a bit. Open the cabinet.
Oh, that blue dye makes me so happy. It means the real Chloe is back with me.
Let's see what we can do about this bird. Is the window open? No. Don't have a repeat of the last time. Alright. What if this bird doesn't exist? It's just something we see to represent Chloe. And when everyone else looks at us, they're just thinking we're crazy. Like, what are you doing? The bird is constantly trapped. No matter how many times we try to let it out the window, it always comes back, stuck here. Go! Be free! Be with your people!
Be free. Since David might be in there, I better mosey along for a change.
Let's mosey.
You won this battle, Max. You broke up my family. I salute you.
David! I didn't try to hurt you. Ever. But I won't let anybody hurt Chloe.
Too late, isn't it? You just better be damn careful with her. Don't you wander off into the dark.
Half regret that previous decision. At the same time, this might be more productive for their family in the long run. Could give him time to think and make regrets. Damn it, Warren, what the fuck? I can hear him just crying in this line here. I have a lot of cool friends, like you. Whatever. Go do your passive crush thing somewhere else.
Looks like David already booked a room. Somehow, I existed in this whole other reality. But I don't know what happened. The more I use my power, the more I see how little control I have over what happens. Now Max Caulfield exists in two, or maybe three different realities. How can I have a destiny? I wonder if Chloe would hate me for keeping her alive. But I couldn't do it. Thinking about all these lifelines almost makes my head hurt worse than the rewind.
I think this game actually does the repercussions for decisions much better than Telltale does, especially recent Telltale.
Looks like they're back on the road to Paris. Ouch. Those poor whales are like beached angels. What is going on here?
Giant, multi-ton, blubbery beached angels. They occasionally make noises like...
Joyce must be so upset. Are you helping anybody, Max?
No.
William never finished painting that wall.
David never had time to finish it. Swing still here.
To think this all started with my vision of a tornado.
I'm sure someone has a legitimate theory. You know, because it's probably ancient aliens.
It looks like David finished his car repairs. Maybe there's some new clues around. What the hell did David do for Nathan? And what did his dad do for David?
Interesting.
Either Chloe stole another gun, or David is out there armed.
Ladder.
Oh, jeez. David is packing up. Oh, that makes me sad. It was so incredible to see William again. I wish Chloe could too. There's more to David Madsen than meets the eye. He should finish this letter to Joyce.
Dark things I've never told you. You are my wife and partner, and I know you should have no secrets. I intend to tell you everything, but I want more proof. Indeed. Instead, a student almost committed suicide on my watch. You kicked me out of my favorite home, and my stepdaughter hates me. Please let me.
I promise I'll help Miss Grant next time. If there is one. Oh, meow, Miss Grant. Twist that knife. At least he has one weird fan.
Libtard metrosexuals.
Wish I had surveillance footage of that conversation. Surveillance cameras at Pan Estates? David must be working for the Prescotts, too.
Is he spying on them, or did he just set it up for him?
I wonder if David is going to the party.
The fact he set up the security system there might explain why he has some kind of inkling of what's going on. Could have discovered something.
Whoa, that is a serious padlock on that locker. Hey, David, what you hiding?
Oh, boy.
For once, I don't have time to search for the code. Oh, I need to find a way to break this padlock. Oh, look at the baby blue jay eggs in the nest. I better move his plank if I want... Excuse me.
Does this mean I just killed these eggs by laying that bird out? This could be one of those asshole... repercussion decisions. You let the bird out of the house every time.
Another photo from my Arcadia Bay wildlife series.
You Shouldn't have let the bird out of the house. It's here for a reason. You may come regret that decision. You had no inkling that was what's gonna happen. But it did.
Okay. I can use that crowbar to pry open the locker.
If it'll happen now. A monster.
Sorry, David, but I bet you would do the same thing as me.
David would be proud. Let's check out the X file.
Maps, notes, coordinates, photos of Kate, Nathan. Yes.
Damn, he went in full detail.
Score. Back to Chloe now. Oh, thank you. Sleep tight, my eggy wags.
I wonder how many people didn't put that thing back. Maybe I should open up a window.
It's amazing how much drama this living room has seen.
Yo, Chloe! Are you ready yet? I have to get back to my dorm.
Are we happy?
Very happy. I hit the secret file jackpot. Kate, Nathan, and Rachel. Plus some location coordinates. David is like a one-man surveillance army. Now let's get the hell out of here before we get busted.
But I absolutely have to go see Kate in the hospital right now. I want to find out how she's doing.
See, Telltale, you've never even visited the hospital. Just give one mini cutscene and all that. I'm still regretting that damn bird.
This is definitely Kate's floor.
The hospitals always freak me out.
I hear you. But imagine how Kate feels. I'm so glad I get to see her again. I hope it's not too weird for her.
No, she'll be stoked to see you. Who wouldn't be?
This be it. I'm a little nervous.
Just go in there and be your friend. I'll wait out here so you can chill by yourselves. I was a total dick for blowing a fuse when you answered Kate's call the other day.
Yes, you were.
Good thing you ignored me. I had no idea what shit she was going through. And you saved her. Like me. I'm sorry.
Thanks. But don't be sorry. We're all on the same team.
Team Matt.
But Kate sounds
knew we're
going to
string Nathan up by his balls then.
Oh, yes. I'm on it.
That's interesting, Buck.
Max!
Kate.
I thought I'd never see you again. I feel so ridiculous. I'm so sorry.
Kate.
The vast majority of people never did see you again.
You have nothing to be sorry about. Other people do. You do not know how happy I am to see you. You look awesome. Is it a stupid question if I ask how you're doing?
Now that you're here, I'm doing even better. I'm so grateful to you for coming up to the roof to talk me down. Max, I felt so lost and alone. When I saw how much you cared, how hard you were trying, you made me realize I wasn't alone. Thank you.
Kate, there are so many people who love you and want to help you.
I know. You should see all the letters and postcards. I gave most of the flowers to other patients here because they need them more than me. I'm keeping the balloons, though. One of the nurses gave me some pen and paper so I could do some drawings.
I love your illustrations.
They got kind of dark there for a while. But I have an idea for a new children's book about bullying. I was thinking of having some photographs in there too.
I hope that's a subtle hint that you'll let me take the photographs for the book.
Was that subtle? You better take the pictures, Max. I'm going to be here for another day until my family comes out to visit.
How are they treating you?
Like they need to protect me forever. They're so upset, and I know they feel guilty even though they didn't do anything. I was surprised how many students from Blackwell wrote me. Daniel, Mr. Jefferson, even Victoria wrote me a very sweet note. And I believe she was being real.
Me too. I'm glad you believe again, Kate.
I'm working on it, Max. I just pray I can get this drawing right.
Oh, I love Kate's happy rainbow flock.
Foxy love. Oregon mustard hot dog man. This one wants a banana. Cat photo. Solid snake.
Good to see that Kate is still working on her book report.
Chair.
It's amazing to just sit here quiet with Kate again. I don't think I'll ever know how much destiny I'm changing. But whoever said we only have a single fate? Time travel is such a mindfuck.
Keeping the balloons, huh?
I don't think get well is quite apropos.
Give him a break. They went to the dollar store. Not much of a choice.
If this gets Kate through the night, so be it. Those are nice flowers. And from Taylor? Wow, props to her. Principal Wells knows how to step it up when he wants to.
I wonder how he's doing without that, you know, handicap fun.
That is so sweet. Even Victoria signed. But not Nathan.
It's because Nathan could go fall off a bridge.
Victoria Chase might be queen bitch, but she's not evil.
Only half evil.
Thank you, sisters. You really saved Kate. Kate, it is so good to hang out with you again.
Max, I owe you so much. And I can tell you want to talk to me about something.
I saw Victoria's letter. How does that make you feel?
Max, I know Victoria can be not nice. But I do believe in forgiveness and redemption. I might be naive, but I feel her struggle.
Me too. I could have taken a picture of her covered in paint, but I didn't, and we had a genuine moment.
We all have our moments. Why do you think she acts so mean?
Bad crowd. Pressure to keep control and power and look cool. Family issues. Nathan.
She's insecure. If you're comfortable with yourself, you don't need to act superior.
Victoria doesn't look like she has much to be insecure about.
If anybody could make Victoria see the light, it would be Kate Marsh.
No. I think it will take more than that, Max.
I always want to talk to you.
We missed our tea session this week.
That was so not cool. We need to plan, like, a tea shop tour of Portland.
Oh, yes. And you could bring Warren along, too.
Oh, I'm sure he would enjoy that. Sorry, Warren.
No boys allowed.
You are funny, Max. And right.
I want you to know I'm this close to getting all the info I need about Nathan.
Nathan Prescott has to pay for what he did. And we have to stop him from hurting anybody else.
Well, I did get his ass suspended, so that might be a start.
You did? Oh, right on, Max. I love how fearless you are. So what is going on with him now?
Both ways are kind of going on.
I assume he'll show up at the Vortex Club party tonight like nothing happened.
And nobody can do anything to him after what he did.
We're going to stop him. I just have to find Nathan's room number, get inside, and get the clues I need.
Max, please let me help. I can get the number, and I'll text it to you, okay?
Of course, Kate. I can't do this without you.
Now it's time for Nathan to watch out for us.
I have to get back to our mission. You don't know how much it means to see you again.
I do. That's why I love you, Max. Thanks for taking care of my bunny. Tell Alice I'll see her soon.
All right, let's roll. That went really well.
Well, how is she?
She's still Kate Marsh. Thank God.
I'm glad we came to see her.
Thanks for coming with me.
Now let's go pay a visit to Nathan Prescott.
Nathan Prescott?
He's not going to be glad when he sees us.
Playing football. People sitting under trees moping. People riding skateboards. Yep, these are teenagers.
Hey, Max. How you doing?
Oh, hi, Mr. Jefferson. I'm okay. And this is my friend Chloe.
Yo.
Chloe? Why isn't somebody as cool as you going to Blackwell?
I was way too cool for this school. It's a long story. In actual files here.
I can imagine. Max, are you sure that you're all right?
It's weird just being on campus like everything's normal.
I know. Lame as it sounds, life has to go on.
I think there's too much going on in my life.
On that note, Blackwell duty calls. Remember, I'm going to announce the winner of the Everyday Heroes contest tonight at the party, so I hope you'll be there to celebrate, even though I'm sorry you didn't enter a photo. I understand your reasons. You can't force an artist to work.
I feel like a total loser, but it's been a hard week to focus. No pun intended.
I'm proud of you for caring so much about
trouble,
and I take hope in the fact that you have plenty of time to find your way. Just get in the habit of putting your work out there.
Thanks, Mr. Jefferson. I'll definitely be there tonight.
Me too. I'll be Max's date. You better dance with us at least once.
Nobody should have to see me dance. Plus, you don't want to watch the old hipster trying to keep up with the kids.
I told you, he's a hipster.
Pride. Be seeing you.
Yes, you will. Hot for teacher.
Gross! You're out of control.
Not yet. Just wait until the rager tonight.
Damn, everyone
Shut
wants
up.
To Mr.
Don't
Jefferson.
Be jealous because Mark Jefferson thinks I'm cool.
I am so ignoring you.
Fine. Since I'm here, I'll see if I can get some dirt from Justin.
Into the hipster classes.
I haven't talked to him in a while.
It's the hipster classes.
Now that is a great plan. Let's see if I can find out where Principal Wells was so loaded the other night here.
If he was loaded before, he's gonna be really loaded now after he found out that money missing.
Hey, Daniel. You look bummed out. Are you alright?
Hola, Max. I just figured out that my photos basically suck. I'm a wannabe artist.
You're not here to be a photographer. That's my gig. Look at that sketch you did of me. Incredible. And that's your art. Your gift.
I do feel better now. You are good, Max.
Thank you.
By the way, have you seen Nathan Prescott?
Oh, I heard a rumor he's actually suspended.
Hey, ain't a rumor,
but
buddy.
He's still gotta be on campus.
That explains why he looked so pissed off when I saw him leaving campus a few moments ago.
That was easy to get that information.
Have you talked to anybody about what happened with Kate?
I don't talk to anyone, Max. But I did actually have a nice talk with Brooke. She couldn't stop talking about how brave you were on that roof.
I don't think doing the right thing is brave, but I appreciate what she means. The most important thing is that Kate gets better and gets justice.
I hear that, Max. She's the sweetest, most genuine person I've ever met. I don't mind getting picked on by Blackwell broholes, but don't fuck with Kate.
I like this revolutionary Daniel Da Costa.
Only if I can start the revolution from my sketchbook, Max.
Are you going to the end of the world party tonight?
It will be if I go, man. People here push me into lockers, not dance floors.
Go for it.
That's exactly why you should go to that party. We have to stand up to these Blackwell bullies for Kate. You won't be alone, Daniel.
Not with you to back me up, Max. Oh, damn it. I will go to the party like it is the end of the world.
Actually, will be.
Okay, maybe I won't go, but... No, I won't do that, but I'll go.
Let's talk later. Okay, Daniel? Good. Nathan is not around. I should go back to Chloe.
It's been so long since I've seen you.
Because you're way too cool for us now, Chloe.
Way too much shit going on, man.
I can tell that Justin is really into Chloe.
Same.
Chloe fits in so easy with Justin.
Rachel. Looks kind of like a young skateboardy Mr. Jefferson in the making.
Coast is clear. It would be so cool if you and me were going to school here together.
But now you can have Mr. Jefferson all to yourself.
Ugh, you suck. Now let's get into Blackwell Ninja.
Could have done some more stuff. Damn it. It is what it is.
So lame they don't have co-ed dorms here.
Yes, because I want Nathan Prescott in the room next door.
Good point.
Wait here. Give me the signal if Nathan or anybody shows up.
I won't let you down, Batmax.
Now I just have to find Nathan's room.
Can I go back out? Damn it.
Max, what are you doing? Hurry up!
Kate brings it. So, room 111 is the magic number. Who would steal cat pics?
My cats.
They have one more meeting left. Evan. Of course. That's why no shits were given. Evan rolls. Oh, why, hello, Trevor. And Dana. Because you care. I'm here with you, right?
This seems about right.
Are toilet paper wars mandatory in the dorms?
This looks like the men's bathroom.
Even after Kate, nobody here learned anything about bullying.
You learned anything about memes, ever.
Sharks. At least nobody messed with the Kate portrait. Zach or Logan? Who knows? Bro's got a bro.
You know what they say about people with big feet? They wear big shoes.
Ugh, skunk weed and video games. I sense Hayden is near.
Come back to you. I'm not gonna make the same mistake.
Hello, Warren's room. Hawking and him make a good team. Poor Warren. This is the work of Nathan. He's so lucky I'm a pacifist.
Nathan is not very creative.
Looks like one of the jocks did care about Kate. Oh, you Bigfoots.
We should be right.
This can only be Nathan's room.
Damn, that's metal as hell.
Now I need to find Nathan's phone. That's so cute and ironic. I can't believe Nathan still has it around.
I think things will kind of work out.
That monochrome camera is brand new and costs about $6,000. Bastard.
It's one of the only decisions I think I regret. I don't think she'll divorce David.
I thought Victoria had the photo bling, but once again, the Prescott's rule. Nathan clearly has his fetish down.
In a doubly creepy way.
That is so Chloe. Oh my god. Chloe. Whale songs? Maybe this is the only soothing thing Nathan ever hears.
He's in the whales. He knows of the coming storm.
That must be the lamp Chloe broke when Nathan drugged her. I don't think one book can guide the Prescotts.
Dr. Bill says, if you're a complete prick, you're probably just a complete prick.
That looks like a totally fun show. Even Nathan has a light side.
That's a nice poster, actually.
Yes, I would be cool with having this high-tech projector. Damn, Nathan. That's a nice shot. If only all your... It's so damn creepy, but... The guy has his own style.
He's pretty much the only photographer I've noticed in the entire game that just, like... Photography?
I don't think this prescription has helped, Nathan.
Not when he's downing a bottle of champagne with it.
I'd cry too if I had him for a father and had to wear that suit.
I'd cry too if I had to dress like Donald Trump!
Welcome to the boys' dorm. Holy shit! That's the gun Nathan used on Chloe. A gift from... Nathan Prescott, all-American teen. Oh man, that dickhead stole one of my selfies.
Creepy.
He has everything in here except peace of mind. These films all have a dark pattern.
Like the dark room.
Nathan likes his tortured subjects way too much. Holy shit. That's the gun Nathan used on Chloe. A gift from... Nathan is way into this party. Bad sign. Oh, bastard. Now I remember why I hate you. And why Kate will get justice. Oh, man. Sean Prescott might be Nathan's real problem. Too bad Nathan isn't more like his sister. She sounds awesome. And far away. Yes, Nathan sure needs diet pills. This is strong stuff. Wow. Kiss ass much, Principal Wells.
Nothing real good yet. Scratch marks.
What the hell are all those marks on the floor?
Shifted the couch?
Let's find out what you're hiding. Oh yes, little phone. You are mine now. Now I have Nathan's phone, so I can show it to Chloe. Well, before Nathan comes back.
Let's cheese it. He's gonna be out here, isn't he? He's gonna be right around the corner. He's waiting for me there.
Max Caulfield, I see you're in here.
Damn, Max, you're
finally
back.
That's what it sounds like, right?
I got worried. So, what did you find?
His room was clean and creepy. Check this out.
Boom, Nathan. We got you by the balls, fucker.
What you say about me?
What are you doing in my dorm?
Ain't your dorm. It's a dude's dorm.
You're such a nosy bitch, Max.
Stop right there, Nathan.
Make me ho.
Nice scratch
Max,
marks in your face.
I got this.
Get the fuck out of my face.
You are so fucking dead!
Damn, CQC.
Get off me, bro!
You're pretty good. No, let's stay out of it.
You like to hurt people, huh? Like Max? Like Kate? Like me? Huh? Feel this, motherfucker!
Ooh, man, that's actually kind of brutal. He did pull a gun on us, though.
Please stop!
It's alright, he just Batman you.
He's down!
It's not bad as long as you're not dead.
Come on!
Stop!
It's the Batman way.
Sorry.
Yes, we have to go! Who's the bitch now?
Chloe!
Damn, Warren went full alpha on Nathan. And it was good. But scary.
Shit, man. This really hurts.
Anything else you want to say while we're here? Before I rewind time and check out the other option? And then come back to this choice anyway. Apologies?
I think my face is broken.
Okay, we know that already. Anything else?
Please, please, please stay away, Nathan.
Hmm? What was that? Hmm? Oh, I'm sorry, your nose is broken. You probably can't talk very well anymore.
Everybody hates me. Everybody.
That's because you put a gun at us and tried to shoot us. Actually, one variation, you did shoot her. I'm enjoying this way too much. Hey, hey Nathan, you like dancing? Check this out. I'm not a good dancer.
Warren, stop it! Come on!
Oh! Oh, my head! Why are y'all looking at me like that, huh? You! And you! You're all dead!
Let's go! Now!
Plus, my dad is on his way! You're all fucked! He owns you!
Okay, there's even if Nathan definitely deserved a beating, we should try to be better than that.
I like how she said this is the right choice and all that jazz. Whatever. I'm telling you, it's Batman rules. He's completely fine, he'll be healed up in about a week or so. Pull out a gun, you get Batmaned. And I was called Batmax.
Shit, man. This really hurts.
Be quiet, Joker. I'm Batmax. I'll see you later. Justice always wins.
Damn. That was intense. Warren, Thank you so much.
For what?
For beating the shit out of Nathan Prescott? Dude, you rule.
I don't know. I kind of went crazy there. Like Nathan.
You're not anything like him.
Good to know. So where are you going? I better stick with you guys. Just in case you need me to get my Hulk on again. Or should I call the cops on Nathan?
So no, you beat the shit out of him, I wouldn't do that.
So maybe you better,
Warren, me and Max have to do this on our own. No offense.
It's cool. Whatever I can do to help.
What you can do is find out anything you can about Nathan's father.
I'm on it. Between the snow and eclipse, I'm assuming the apocalypse is around the corner.
And thank you. Seriously. I'll call you later.
You better. I'm feeling pretty alpha now.
Yes, you are.
Man, that guy is so fucking in love with you.
I know.
He really did give a serious beatdown to Nathan.
It was a little scary to watch him do that.
Now let's make a date with Frank.
Will he even answer you?
Frank always answers when he wants money. Like I said, Frank wants to see me right now.
Let's not keep him waiting.